Are you ready to wake up to your full potential? That is something everyone wants for their life, meeting our full potential. But first, you actually have to wake up, an hour earlier at least. Nothing changes if nothing changes. Do you have limitations? For me personally, I'm a mom and I don't have very much help. Maybe you have a ridiculous amount of responsibilities as it is. Do not let that devastate you. Do not be a victim. Take responsibility for your life. Accept your situation, but do not dwell on it. Do not focus on your limitations ever. Always focus on your advantages. Focus all your energy, emotion, attention on what you do want and keep moving in that direction. After sleeping 8 or so hours, your body is dehydrated. Before you do anything, get a full glass of water and hydrate your brain and body. And take your vitamins too. After I hydrate, I like to read and journal. My first thing on the list to read is a devotional I've been reading. It's called Unshakable. It's by Christine Kane. And I really have been enjoying it a lot. And after I read my devotional, I read some kind of personal development book. And right now I am currently reading The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson. And this book is incredible and absolutely will change your life if you read it. At the beginning of each year, my family and I started this thing where we pick a word for each year. And I picked a few for this year. They were self-awareness, discipline, and focus. And something that has helped immensely with those three things has been journaling. When I read my devotion and my personal development book, I write down the things that stand out to me and the things that apply to me most. And I really just do a big brain dump. I write down everything that's on my mind. Sometimes I do this in the morning and at night. And I'll also write down the things that I'm grateful for, because really, if you're living in a space of gratitude, it's really hard to be stressed. I know right now, the small things you're doing, the tiny, seemingly insignificant steps you take every day seem like they're not doing much. And I know you may feel like you're alone. Nobody sees the hard work you put in day after day after day, but one day you will arrive. In fact, those steps you have been taking will eventually snowball into a huge, massive success that people cannot ignore. People will be saying, "Wow, I wish I could make it big like her, have her body, see the kind of success she has seen. She just blew up. She just lost so much weight. Her life suddenly and drastically changed." But what they don't realize is that there was nothing sudden about it. You have simply been taking the right steps, steps that empower you, over and over and over again. A quiet progress that was producing small, invisible results that only you can see. That's the secret sauce, sis. Anything worth having takes time. You might not know right now everything you need to build the business, restore your health, become physically fit, write a book, or even start a YouTube channel. But I can promise you without a doubt that if you take that first step and keep taking small steps every single day to become who you need to be and learn what you need to learn, you will be successful. I've heard it said that your level of success will seldom exceed your level of personal development, because success is something you attract by the person you become. Now that Rosalie is awake, you see that I have already fed her and it's time to make myself a healthy and very filling breakfast. If you want the full recipe for this breakfast, I included both of them in my most recent What I Eat in a Day video. Something that is missing from this morning routine, you'll have noticed that I have not included being on my phone, scrolling through social media, or checking my notifications. I actually do not get on my phone until I eat my first meal. The internet, social media, and just smartphones in general can turn into a huge distraction, so I make sure to set my intention for the day before I even touch it. If you have a hard time feeling motivated in the morning, here's what I recommend. Change your clothes, splash some ice-cold water on your face, or wash your face, and moisturize. I also wanted to do something with my hair. Normally, I wouldn't actually get ready to this extent because I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I need to stay in my yoga pants, you know. But this morning, we were actually going to church because this was Sunday, so I did a little bit more than usual. I gave myself a little dry blowout to get rid of that obnoxious bump in the back of my head. A huge tip is to brush your teeth. If you wake up in the morning and do your morning routine without brushing your teeth, you're gonna lack motivation. I know it sounds cray cray, but try it and you will believe me. Another major key is set your intention the night before. Tidy up, get your space ready for the next morning. I'm not perfect at this, but I notice a huge difference in productivity when I wake up to a clean house. But if you have to stay up too late to clean, forget about it. Sleep is so much more important. Getting 7 to 8 hours of sleep a night should be a non-negotiable.
Another non-negotiable should be exercise. I personally enjoy exercising, and I know I can hold myself accountable to it, but I like exercising at night right now. Make sure you're getting in at least 20 minutes of exercise a day.
Proverbs 4:23 through 27 says, "Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the paths for your feet and be steadfast in all your ways." All right, you guys, we are at church. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're new. I really, really just want to help my subscribers become their most healthy and thriving selves, finding joy and empowerment through healthy living, and really just help you overall live a more vibrantly alive life. So if that's something you want to do, make sure you subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you never miss a new video by me. All right, you guys, we'll talk very, very soon. Bye-bye.